So we're going to talk about a couple special characteristics of sequences, the first of which is called monotonic. Now, monotonic just means it's doing the same thing in terms of either increasing or decreasing. So monotonic increasing or decreasing means that the function is always increasing or decreasing. And so, for example, if I looked at this sequence, and we start listing out a few terms, 1/2, 1/3, 1/4, you'll notice that these are always getting smaller, right? In other words, an plus 1 is always less than an. And so this we would call monotonic decreasing. Now you can compare that to sort of an extreme example, something like an equals cosine of n, which is going to oscillate up and down. This is certainly not monotonic increasing or decreasing. It's neither. Okay, so that's the idea of monotonic. So then the other concept we're going to talk about is the idea of bounded. So a sequence is bounded if there is some value that it never gets higher than or some value it never gets lower than. That's either bounded above or bounded below. So, for example, again, an equals 1 over n. Notice that if n, since n is always a whole number, since n is always positive, 1 over n will always be positive. This is always greater than 0. And so that this is bounded below by 0. Now, we also know that this is decreasing, which means it's always getting smaller. So it's also bounded above by whatever the starting value is. In this case, it's 1. Right? So this sequence is both bounded above and below. And there is a theorem which says that every bounded monotonic sequence converges. And let's think about why. So imagine we have a sequence of values, and we know that those values never get smaller than that value. So this is sort of the bounded below value, and never get larger than this. And suppose that in this particular case it is monotonic increasing. So we know that our sequence is always getting larger and larger, but can never get larger than this blue value, than this output value. So we have two options. Either we get to that value and then stay there, or we slowly approach that value but never quite get there, or we approach some value that's even smaller and we just didn't realize that there was an even lower bound. But no matter what we do, it has to converge to a value. There is no other option. Now notice that both conditions are necessary. If the sequence wasn't bounded, it could just continue on increasing forever and ever. If the sequence wasn't monotonic, it could just go up and down forever and ever and never converge at any value. But if it's both bounded and monotonic, it's going to have to converge. So a nice example of that is this 1 over n sequence, which we can tell is going to converge to 0 as n gets large. And as we can see here, it is monotonic decreasing and bounded below. Okay?